What do you hear? I hear that bird. I kind of hear a frog. No, you hear a community. This is an ecosystem. We're in a wetland. And it's just an ecosystem full of life. It's a very good example of biodiversity on Rayonier's land base. Welcome to Rayonier. I'm Ben Cazell, Manager of Sustainable Forestry. We're going to talk about biodiversity throughout the day, and pretty excited to have you here.
The same forests that provide the wood and paper products you use every day are teeming with life. We're able to protect and even create a wide variety of wildlife and fish habitats while managing, harvesting, and replanting our forests. Rayonier sustainably manages more than 2 million acres of land in the United States. That gives us the unique ability to protect large, continuous wildlife corridors where animals can safely roam. In fact, we protect about 12,000 miles of waterways in our forests. In those areas, we establish large buffer zones where little, if any, harvesting takes place.
All those zones, we do not apply any herbicides or fertilizers. No chemicals go in there. It's a buffer. And so it provides protection to water quality. And we, in our activities where we are intensively managed, will, based on topography, design our activity so that we don't even run the chance of negatively impacting or needing that filter strip. But it's just an area that we've decided to protect, and that's a good thing.
In the areas where we do harvest and replant trees, there are a variety of habitats. Different species have different needs. Some prefer open areas, which occur just after a harvest. Some want to browse among young trees as they grow, and others prefer a mature forest. Our activities naturally provide ample habitat for each. We limit the size of our harvests and the number of harvests each year in a given area. This ensures a variety of forest ages in one place. This diversity of ages, as well as the mix of natural protected wetlands and waterways, creates what we call a mosaic of habitats. If you look at one of our forests from above, it is laid out like a patchwork quilt. Each section of forest serves the needs of different groups of species. By managing our forest this way, we're actually creating a larger variety of habitats for wildlife than unmanaged forests could provide alone.
If you were to think of this as us not owning this land and not managing it the way we do, would all the species that we're providing habitat to still be out here? Yes. Because of natural fires, because of natural large storm events would knock stuff down. But it wouldn't be, let's say, at the abundance that we might provide through our activities.
Just look at this map of habitat types on one of our Florida properties. Each color represents a habitat for a different group of species. Even a cleared forest is important to certain species.
In an open area where we might have just harvested, you'll see a lot of mammals move into that. A lot of small, like mice, small snakes, etc. They're all feeding on one another. But then you get your predator birds, your hawks and whatnot. Not as many of those, but they need that opening and those species to capture and take an opportune time to populate there so they have something to eat.
After we harvest a softwood forest, we typically replant the next generation of trees within about a year, always choosing tree species that are native to the area. We plant many times more trees than we harvest. The new forests will grow and provide habitats for the next 25 to 45 years. Then there are the trees we don't plant and rarely harvest. About a third of our land is made up of natural wetlands and hardwood forests, which are rich in foods and provide a home for a large variety of species. We harvest these forests only once or twice a century, if ever. and then they naturally reseed themselves and continue growing. We want to see all species thrive on our properties. When it comes to protected species, we take special precautions to look out for them. Our foresters are trained to recognize their habitats. For example, if they see an active gopher tortoise burrow or an eagle's nest, they will take note of the location and ensure our work doesn't get too close to their homes.
So, in a nutshell, a working forest like Rayonier works. It provides clean air because trees fix carbon dioxide, produce oxygen in the process. It provides clean water because we're buffering those water strips. And then obviously, it provides jobs.
By voluntarily meeting the highest sustainability standards in the forestry industry, we protect important wildlife habitats, and so do many of our peers. You can do your part by purchasing forest products marked with one of these three sustainable forestry certifications: the Sustainable Forestry Initiative, the Program for the Endorsement of Forest Certification, the Forest Stewardship Council.
We've managed this part of the world for almost 100 years, and it is doing just as well now as it was then. You don't see an addition of listed species of concern, because we've been doing a good job of protecting their residents. Not only Rayonier employees, and I'm proud of every one of those and the stewardship that they take, but it trickles down to the contractors that we hire. They understand what our expectations are, and they embrace in that as well. And collectively, you know, it takes all of us to do a good job. And I, you know, that investment makes me feel very good about what I do.